Hi everybody! I know it's been a very long time, but I have been working a full-time job and also doing other things, so I haven't really had time to sit down and like make a YouTube video. But after 5 years of waiting, I finally managed to go to a Hollywood Vampires concert, and it was like a spiritual experience. I wanted to make a video of me going to this concert. I kind of tried to make it a vlog, but I kind of suck at vlogging, so you can skip to this point if you just want to watch videos from the concert, but if you want to watch the whole thing, you can watch the whole thing. I did film a lot of songs in full, which will probably get me a copyright strike, but I don't care. Also, as you will see throughout it, the video quality starts to go down, as in it's kind of moving all over the place, and that's because I was standing next to like three or four really, really drunk people who were getting in physical fights with each other. They kept bumping into me and it kept moving the camera. There were so many things about this concert that just like, it was insane to experience. I've seen Johnny Depp perform live before, and obviously I was in Fairfax for all 6 weeks of the trial. I've seen him in real life, like every day for 6 weeks. Like, I'm pretty used to being in front of him, but I've never seen him perform these songs before, or Heroes, or anything like that. So, again, a spiritual experience. Also, I've never seen Alice Cooper perform before, and it is so refreshing to see, like, somebody actually performing instead of just singing, like, with no emotion at all. Usually, like, somebody performing, and it's not like a performance like someone else came up with it. It's clearly he came up with this and it's his own thing, and that was so refreshing to see. And you could also tell everyone on that stage was just like really good friends with each other, and they were like joking around and like just having a really good time. And honestly, I have never seen Johnny Depp that happy, even at the Jeff Beck concert, which he was happy and smiling at that. I've never seen him as happy as I did in Boston. And I think it had to do mostly with the audience, because the audience at the Jeff Beck concert was very much like there for Jeff Beck, whereas the audience in Boston, I would say about 85 to 90% of them were only there to see Johnny Depp. Because when they were playing the original Hollywood Vampire songs, like their original songs, nobody knew them except me. Maybe like a couple other people, but I was like yelling all the words, and then I just kind of like turned and looked and I was like, does no one else know this? Has no one else ever heard this before? They all knew the Alice Cooper songs, but they didn't know their original songs. And it was just like, you people are only here because you want to see Johnny Depp in real life. Which, like, you do you. Also, it is a very little known fact that Johnny Depp actually wrote all the words to their songs, or almost all the words to their songs. Alice Cooper said when the album first came out that pretty much all of the lyrics are based off of poetry that Johnny had written for years during, you know, what he calls the madness. There's a certain chunk of the internet that seems to have completely missed this, which I find very interesting. And I brought it up several times, but it's just going right over their head. I'm like, how can you not, you don't notice this? You don't notice that, like, you know, a certain someone wrote an extortion letter and somehow the list of things she was asking for ended up in a song of Johnny Depp's band? You didn't notice this? Like, you can look at the first verse of their, like, main single, Who's Laughing Now? And if you break it down line by line, it is talking about, it was this huge movement that took down the, like, elites of what's considered Hollywood. And it was all fake. And now they're being fed, people on the internet are being fed lies that they think are true, and they're just tweeting about it, and these lies are being fed by what they call forever creeps, aka journalists, paparazzi, and the media. I don't know how you can listen to these songs and not realize that, or even, not even listen to them, just look at the words and not realize what this is about. So I always find it very interesting, and I found it very interesting that during the trial, they never brought up this album, even though it was stated that he wrote the lyrics, and it's pretty obvious who they were about. They never brought it up because I don't think she actually thinks it's about her, or she's just really fucking stupid. So anyway, I have been a fan of this album since it debuted, I think in 2019, and I think they started singing songs from it in 2018. So it's been a good 5 years that I've been following this band and following their tour. I already knew what was gonna happen at this show because I've been following it on Twitter for the past couple months that it's been going on. This concert, I wasn't even supposed to go to it because I didn't have tickets until after it was rescheduled. And what I find really interesting too is every single time a show either was canceled or rescheduled, these people decided to come up with this incredible story that Johnny Depp had passed out, somehow turned into he had died. I just want to say, I'm very happy to report that I was watching him for about 2 hours from the front row of the theater, not the VIP section, but the front row of the theater, and he was perfectly fine. He was not high, he was not drunk, he was not dead, he was not on the verge of a medical crisis. You know, there's something called the weather, there's something called, you know, management of the theater. There's a million factors that go into creating a show like this, and if one of those things goes wrong, you can't have the show. It's not just one person causing this. Every day I am shocked by how stupid people really are. It constantly shocks me. So anyway, that's my experience. Now you may watch the video, and if you watch the end, you will see the absolute emotional state I was in after this concert, because oh my god. But anyway, thank you in advance for watching, and I will see you all whenever I decide to make another video or have the time to do it. Good morning. It is 8 a.m. and the concert is not for another 12 hours, but I have to go on a 4-hour train ride, and in order to get there, I have to go to the city, which takes a bit. So, good morning.
Dee, why are you sleeping on the floor? Dee, you know you could sleep in my bed. He is dead asleep, or pretending to ignore me, I don't know.
It's clean. It's time to go. Yay.
Bye, Dave. I think he has found a bird. You found a bird? Oh, yeah, it's in the tree. Bye, Dave. I'll see you in a couple days.
I look very orange right now. Okay, I'm outside waiting for the Uber because I gotta go all the way to New York City, and in order to do that, I have to take an hour-long train. Sometimes it's half an hour, but because it's not peak hours, it is peak. This concert was actually not supposed to happen because it was scheduled for May, and I was hella busy. But then Johnny Depp broke his ankle, which really sucks for him, but then I was able to get tickets. So, and not just tickets, like, people had to resell their tickets because people could no longer, like, make the concert. I got tickets for $120 in the front row. The front row, because there's actually two front rows. There's the theater front row, and then when they do, like, concerts, they put seats in the pit orchestra, and that's the actual front row. I got seats in like the theater front row, row A, which is the best seats I've ever gotten to anything, for $120. Very sadly though, I didn't get meet and greet tickets, which I really wanted, but I couldn't get because they were sold out by the time I noticed they were on sale. Yay! All right, I must go catch my Uber, take like an hour long train ride. I made it. That was an adventure. The site I booked the hotel on kind of fucked something up, so that was much longer than I anticipated. Anyway, look at this. I have literally never been in a hotel by myself before. This is crazy, and I like it. I don't even know what to do. Like, this is just like so much more luxurious than I thought it was going to be. This is so cool. It's so nice. Okay, I gotta go get ready now because it is almost 5:30 and I was supposed to be here at 4. So like, yeah. So my dumbass forgot to bring makeup remover and also my earrings, which I'm very sad about. Very sad. So this is the finished look. I put on mascara and that's it. It is 6 o'clock though, so I think, I don't know when the doors open, but it doesn't say. So I feel like I should probably start heading out. I don't know why, because the show doesn't start for 2 hours, but for some reason I just feel like they open at 6. This bed is memory foam. Also, I have made the discovery based on people that I know that the meet and greet is canceled, which that really sucks for them. I mean, I've been like trying to find meet and greet tickets to the show, and I have not been able to find them anywhere. And I missed the day that they were like originally released because I didn't know. So I never got meet and greet tickets. Can you imagine if I had gotten meet and greet tickets? Before the annoying bitches on the internet say anything, it is not because of Johnny Depp. They had complications with their flight. I know this because I know people who know his security guards because of Virginia. So like, they said it was complications from their flight because there have been so many thunderstorms here lately, like just non-stop thunderstorms. It's like this and then it's like thunderstorms. So I'm not surprised, honestly. And we're also in a heat wave, so for some reason that's affecting travel. I don't know why, but it is. So that is why the meet and greet was canceled. It had nothing to do with Johnny Depp. Before people start saying that he died, passed out, tried to kill himself. I mean, I've seen a lot of things. And y'all are all wrong. It's called the weather. We learned about it in kindergarten. Maybe even before that. So yeah, in conclusion, that is that. I guess I'm gonna head over now.
I wouldn't mind. Just want to take this into the world. Friend of the TV, we lost in January. Tragedy of Mr. Jeff Beck. We want to do something for Jeff. And we do have a like to introduce you to his second best friend. Right on.
a must. Thank you so much, Boston.
We'll be right back.
I literally just walked in here and started crying. I can't hear. I cannot hear right now. Like, I can't even, like, my voice sounds weird because I can't hear myself properly. Oh my god. I need food. What the fuck? I have souvenir. You ready? Souvenirs. And we got Buck Johnson and focus. Joe Perry. It's not. There you go. I didn't catch them. I just want to say I picked them off of the ground because he didn't throw them toward our side. Actually, like, no one did. So when the show was over, I ran to the other side and just found them on the ground because y'all be missing shit. I have waited 6 years now. I don't know how many years. Six years. How long ago was 2018? 5 years? I have waited 5 years to see them live. Because when they came out with that album, and I knew that Johnny wrote the words to all the songs that are like original songs of that album, I spent hours breaking that shit down like I did with Nirvana. And I will never be able to see Nirvana live. So this is pretty fucking close. I cannot believe how happy Johnny Depp is now. That's inspiring. I don't know what else to say or do. What the fuck? That was crazy, bitch.